sometimes I The Allman Brothers, 1971, at the Fillmore. Wow. Wow. Whipping Post is one of the songs when I was a late teen, early 20-year-old, you always played, and it was so long, but you didn't mind the length. It's just one of those great jam tunes that just lives up to its reputation. Hi, I'm your cousin Dave. This is Why the Blues from KBLP. And once again, you can find us on all the KBLP podcasts on Facebook, iTunes, iHeart, YouTube, Twitter, and Spreaker. Well, we're going to continue on. Oh, I should mention a few more things about the Fillmore East album. Once again, like I mentioned earlier, in 2004, it was selected for preservation in the Library of Congress, deemed to be culturally, historically, or aesthetically important by the National Recording Registry. And it is. It's a true treasure. One of the great live albums of all time. And it's like a snapshot into what was going on in 1971. It's a term I don't particularly... I'm from the South, or from Virginia, and I'm not always that keen on the term Southern rock. I prefer just rock, blues rock. But the one cool thing about the Allman Brothers, they were probably the only band of that era that were tagged with the Southern rock thing that had a black member. Johnny Johnson was a great musician, drums, congas, timbales, and he helped round out their sound. But Dwayne's guitar and Gregg's vocals and keyboards, and of course Dickie Betts on guitar, well, every musician on there. Barry Oakley on bass, Butch Trucks on drums. They just created a sound that was just spectacular. Just wonderful, wonderful sound.